Good day, grade 11 students. Welcome to Bamboo Teleskuela. This is your school on air in empowerment technologies. I am teacher Jane, joining you in the next 30 minutes. Make sure to have your module with you, as well as your pen and paper, and set your mind as you are going to have another lesson in the subject. Today's episode, we will venture with online collaborative tools to develop an ICT content. But before we dig deeper to this lesson, let us have first a brief recapitulation of the previous topic. In the previous weeks, Teacher Menchu helped us discover the so-called online platforms, its nature and purpose in achieving a certain objective. She had clearly defined that online platforms are based of technologies designed to run within an online environment and provides interactivity among its users. These online platforms are basically online web pages that allows the user to create another page for the others to interact with. And with the ingenious minds of IT individuals, from a web pages, software engineers were able to create online applications that equivalently accessible like web pages, which are the things that we are installing in our handheld devices like smartphones, tablets, and laptops. These online platforms can be categorized with the following categorization, but are not limited to the social media platforms, the presentation or visualization web applications, the web page creation platforms, the cloud computing, the file management, the mapping applications, and the blogging platforms. At this point, be ready as we are going to begin our learning session. This week, we are going to talk about the online collaboration for collaborative development of ICT content. Together as a team, we will identify the different players in an online collaboration, understand the nature and purpose of online collaboration, explore the different tools for online collaboration, and lastly, evaluate the quality, value, and appropriateness of peers' existing or previously developed ICT content in relation to the team or intended audience viewer of an ICT project. With this, let's get started. What is collaboration? According to whatis.com, collaboration is a joint effort of multiple individuals or work groups to accomplish a task or project. It can be done through offline and online state. Technology plays an integral role in widening the scope and definition of collaboration. It is where collaboration can exist despite of not having a face-to-face interaction of a certain group in a normal setup or meetings. Distance has no longer a barrier to work as one. And now, what is online collaboration? Online collaboration refers to the tools and platform people use to work together within a digital environment. In most cases, it refers to how people work together over the internet. The online platform's skills from the previous learnings into an integrated ICT content through collaboration with a classmates and teachers as both peer and partner. This time, let's talk about the nature and purpose of collaborative tools. Online collaboration is the process of connecting users digitally to communicate in an online space and collaborate with each other to generate content, reflection, review, modification that is visible to other collaborators. Online collaboration is usually supplemented using a software system that lets team members chat using video, audio, and text. Using online collaborative tools or applications allows online collaborators work together on text documents, PowerPoint presentations, video chats, or detailed brainstorming projects. The idea is that users do not need to be in the same room at the same time to work together. There are many online collaboration tools available. A web conference allows people to meet online and deliver presentations, but it's not necessarily the same thing as an online collaboration tool. Online collaboration specifically involves a team working together, often at the same time, and on the same projects and documents. In an online collaboration, the person working together are called collaborators, which are given access to input and modify the content. There is what we call team structure and dynamics for ICT content development. In a certain online project, a project team is a team whose members usually belong to different groups, functions, and are assigned to activities of the same project. A team can be divided into sub-teams according to need. Team structure is composed of the following: team manager, editorial manager, content curators, analytic expert, and website manager. First among the member of the team structure is in the team manager. Team manager is the one who sets priorities and communicates with the executive team. He or she also contributes or creates content and keeps the team organized and motivated. He or she leads the group to keep on track. Next is the editorial manager. Editorial manager is one who implements the strategy and maintains an editorial calendar and guides content producers and writers and the designers. We do also have the content curators. Content curators are the one who gave input ideas into organization by searching for any interesting resource, materials online and over broadcasting. They are the one who feeds what are the needed information to develop an interesting topic. Next is analytic expert. They constantly looking at the data to determine what is going viral, checking whether the content is meeting the objectives and goals of the sites and analyzing the website traffic. And we also have the website manager. Website manager are the one who organizes and puts contents into the platform, whatever is agreed contents. He or she makes a regular monitoring and update with the website's content. We also have the positions of writer, editor, producer, and designer. Writers are the one who writes a long or short-term content, a creative product of human mind which can be an article, literary pieces. We do also have the editor. They are the one who edits the work of the writer. Next is the producer. Producers are the one who creates video and audio outputs. And lastly, the designer. Designers are responsible of creating and layouting the visual content of the web page or the canvas. The positions of writer, contributor, and editor in the team can be combined with other positions, especially when there are only few members. And there are different online collaborative tools that a team can use to manage their work. These tools can be categorized according to its function, which can be as follows: voicemail, video call, email, instant messaging, social media, and cloud-based collaborative tools. First on the list is the online collaborative tools category is the voicemail. Voicemail is computer-based system that allows users and subscribers to exchange personal voices messages. The sender may record a voice and will send to the receiver's account. We do also the video call. Under this category, this requires the team players and members to have a multimedia sessions over internet where individuals can see the faces of their participants. They can virtually discuss the matters regarding the project. The best thing about this is that they can have a real-time discussion about the project as if they are having face-to-face discussion. Another is through email or the electronic mail. This is the exchanging of digital messages between computer users where both the receiver and the sender can also attach files. Another of this category is the instant messaging. Using an instant messaging, applications allows the team to have an online chat which covers real-time text transmission over the internet. Under this one, we have the social chat. The social chat lets the team collaborate and interact using chatting applications. It is a two-way communication tool for communication. Examples of these are the Google Chat, Hangouts, Skype, Viber, KakaoTalk, WeChat, LINE, and Facebook Messenger. Because of the rampant use of social media online, social media can now also be used for online collaboration. Users need to create an account for them to interact with. Under this, we have the Facebook, WordPress, blog, microblogging as its example. Particularly, some of the examples of social media platforms for online collaborations are the Facebook groups. This is a group page that will allow people in your group to communicate your ideas. It requires the admin to add the member to give privacy to the team. Sometimes, it can also be set as a closed group. Another example of this social media is the WordPress. This platform is popular in creating web pages, which allows to have multiple contributors for a single blog or page. Popular cloud-based collaborative tools are Google Drive and Microsoft Office Online. These applications allow multiple people to work on different office files and even have their own group's cloud storage. The good thing about this is it can be on a real-time base, meaning the group can input data on a single file and at the same time. Then, we have the project management for ICT content. Content Management System, or CMS, is a computer application that supports the creation and modification of digital content using a common user interface, thus usually supporting multiple users working in a collaborative environment. Some CMS are built on top of separate content management frameworks like Java, Microsoft ASP.NET, PHP, MySQL, JavaScript, and Perl. Examples of CMS are WordPress. It is a free and open source content management system based on PHP and MySQL. Second is the Joomla. It is a free and open source WCMS built on a MVC framework. Joomla is written in PHP and offers features such as caching, RSS feeds, blogs, search, and support for language internationalization. And lastly, Drupal. It is a free open source content management framework written in PHP and distributed under the GNU General Public License. provides a back-end framework for at least 2.2% of all websites worldwide. Part of the online collaborative team is the content curator, who is responsible for curating existing content for use on the web. But what is content curation? Content curation is the act of discovering, gathering, and presenting digital content that surrounds specific subject matter. That is according to Mulan in the year 2011. This can be blogs, images, audio, and video from different sources. Example of these tools to curate content for social media and newsletters. Examples of these are Pinterest. It is a web and mobile application company that operates a photo sharing website. Uses pins to curate images, items, moments, and code. Next is Trapit. It is a comprehensive content curation service for business that offers content, discovery, curation, and publishing to web and social channels through its web applications. And lastly, Feedly. It is a news aggregator application for various web browsers and mobile devices. It compiles news feeds from a variety of online sources for the users to customize and share with others. I hope that you were able to understand the key concepts regarding the online collaboration for teamwork. Again, let us have a quick review of the things that we have discussed for today's episode. Online collaboration refers to the tools and platforms people use to work together within a digital environment. It is the process of connecting users digitally to communicate in an online space and collaborate with each other to generate content, reflection, review, modification that is visible to other collaborators. Online collaboration is usually supplemented using a software system that lets team members chat using video, audio, and text. Online collaborative tools can be categorized as follows: voicemail, video call, email, instant messaging, social media, and cloud-based collaborative tools. I hope that you will practice the things that you have understood today, especially when you are tasked to have a group work in a convenient way using online collaborative tools. Work done faster when you work collaboratively. Remember that you can improve your skills, so continue investing time to explore with our ICT tools. Continue reading and scanning your module for further understanding. You may also start doing activities intended in order to apply the learnings that we have. If you still have questions and clarifications, write down in your module and or message your empowerment technology teacher. Remember that education must continue amidst the crisis. Again, this is Teacher Jane for Bamboo Teleskwela, bringing education in the comfort of your home. Stay safe and goodbye.